Hey, it's Clay, and this will be a video chart on ticker symbol CMCM. We will take a look at the 30-minute time frame. Real quick, what do I mean by 30-minute in case maybe you're new to charts? Instead of each one of these candlesticks here representing one day's worth of price action, which is what you would normally see, each one represents 30 minutes. So while this here may look like several days worth of time, it's actually today's price action broken down into 30-minute time slices. I like to do this time frame, and it does a good job of telling the quote-unquote story of the price, and then makes mapping out levels of support and resistance a bit easier to see. I don't mean to state the obvious, but I will anyways. Very nice movement today, not only from a price action perspective, but you look down here at the volume, and definitely above average volume on the day. So a lot of eyeballs on this one, so let's map out some levels of support, and then we can talk areas of resistance. So the first level of support is what I would call the ideal level. I mean, if you were to say, hey, Clay, what would make this chart look the absolute strongest going forward? That would be if the price can stay up above this previous breakout point down here around the $7 mark. Now, don't get me wrong. If the price falls below 7, by no means am I saying the entire chart's broken or ruined or anything like that. But yeah, if the price can manage to stay up above that area, that would definitely be a huge sign of power going forward. Taking a step back and looking at things from more so a bigger picture point of view, that is where the purple line here comes into play, the famous 50-period simple moving average. Keyword being moving. As time goes by, that line is going to move itself higher and higher. So a very basic yet highly effective way to judge the health of the move, this right here being defined as quote-unquote the move, just watch that purple line. As long as the price stays above that line, as the line itself moves higher and higher, then the bulls are in full health, the bulls are in full control. However you can best visualize that, you know, that's what's being represented. Again, sure, staying above $7, that would be great. However, from the big picture of it all, as long as the price is above that purple line, the bulls 100% own the chart. Now, what about levels of resistance? As far as where the sellers are hanging out at, nothing complicated behind this at all, other than the fact that the party stopped today right up there at $7.50. On a couple of different occasions, you can see the price did try to break up through there, but you know the price just couldn't quite muster it up. So that'll be the key area to focus on going forward from the resistance standpoint. But all in all, as long as the price continues to chip away and build higher bases like it's been doing for the past few days, then everything else will take care of itself, including breaking levels of resistance. So resistance levels matter, sure, but they almost don't matter because as long as you build those higher lows and go through healthy consolidations, like I said, given enough time, everything else will take care of itself. So focus on consolidating healthily and let the trend do its thing. One of the biggest questions I get is, hey, Clay, how do you find the stocks that you trade? So what I've done is put together a free resource guide where I talk about the tools that I use to locate stocks that I find interesting and think may have potential. So if that sounds like something that could add value to you as a trader, then click on the image that is up on the screen right now, and I will email you the guide. The guide itself is very short and to the point, and best part, it's completely free. Thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any questions.